Hey everyone, how's it going? Today we're gonna be talking about how to shop for healthy food at the grocery store, okay? So I'm gonna give you 6 tips that you can start using when you go to the grocery store to make it easier for yourself, that you can think of these tips while you're doing grocery shopping, okay? If you have a way of writing some of these things down, I would recommend it, especially as we get closer to the bottom. I'm gonna be talking about some ingredients that you need to look out for when you are shopping for food, and just to be mindful of. Again, I'm not trying to scare you into not buying foods with these ingredients. I just want you to be educated, okay? None of this stuff is gonna kill you overnight, all right? Some of these things you wanna try to watch out for on a regular basis. But again, I'm not trying to create fear and fear-mongering. I just wanna educate you on some of the things that's in your food so that you can make the proper decisions, okay? So the very first one is stay on the perimeter of the grocery store, okay? 9 grocery stores out of 10 are going to have all of their produce, all of their dairy, all of their meat, all of their whole food nutrition on the perimeter of the grocery store, okay? You will find things like peanut butter and almonds and nuts and seeds and things like that, probably in some aisles here and there, but the majority of your whole food nutrition is going to be on the perimeter of the store. So what does this mean? It means that your highly processed foods are gonna be in the frozen food section, are gonna be in those middle aisles. So if you're trying to buy the bulk of your nutrition and you're trying to cook a lot of things from scratch and you have the time to kind of do all of this, staying on the perimeter of the store is your best bet. That's where you're gonna find the most nutritious food, okay? So again, it doesn't mean that you can't buy, you know, pastas. It doesn't mean that you can't buy breads. It doesn't mean that you can't buy, you know, packaged food here and there, but you wanna try to reduce the amount of processed food that you're buying, if you're buying a lot of it. If most of your diet comes from processed food, if you simply remember this, staying on the perimeter and buying things on the perimeter of the store, you'll have a much easier time getting whole food nutrition, okay? So number 2 is gonna be reduce the amount of bagged and boxed foods that you buy, okay? Another reason for this is, or kind of going off number 1, number 2, most processed foods are gonna be in bags and boxes. Now there's plenty of whole foods that will be in bags, things like bags of apples, bags of broccoli, bags of green beans. So a lot of things that come in bags aren't processed food, but crackers, chips, cakes are usually boxed. Pastas, especially the variety that aren't, you know, that have virtually no fiber in them whatsoever, they're gonna come in bags and boxes, okay? So just be mindful of some of the bagged and boxed foods and ask yourself, is this bag of broccoli processed in any way? And 9 times out of 10, it won't be, because there's really nothing to do to broccoli other than maybe cut it up. But as you start to see things like potato chips and crackers and cookies and things like that, you'll start to notice that a lot of those foods have additives and preservatives that keep them fresh for long periods of time. And if you know anything about rotting food, is that it doesn't last very long, all right? Because a lot of whole food doesn't have preservatives in them. All right, number 3, the fewer the ingredients, the better. So if you're looking at a, you know, bag of chips or a box of cookies, or you're looking at you know, a box of pasta or a cereal, a lot of times the ingredient list will be a laundry list long, right? It'll be really long and it'll have lots of ingredients, and a lot of them you probably won't even be able to pronounce, or there'll be some derivative of an additive or sugar or sodium or something like that. So when you're looking at an ingredient list, the classic example I like to give is like a bag of chips versus like a jar of peanut butter. A jar of peanut butter should really only say peanuts and salt at the, excuse me, at the very most. Where you get peanut butters like Jif, where it has like hydrogenated vegetable oil or hydrogenated whatever, and it has 2% of all these other ingredients. So if something has a long list of ingredients, it's additives, it's sugar, it's salt, it's in a lot of cases things that you don't necessarily need. Now, in some cases, things like peanut butter, if it has added salt, that's not that big a deal, right? I'm not too worried about that. But hidden sugars is a really big thing. Lots of food companies like to add sugar in their food, even when it doesn't need to be there, to get you to want to eat more of it, right? Sugar is a very addictive substance, and a lot of people like to pretend that sugar is just like any other calorie, and I have a very hard time believing that.